So, you've got a new camera and you're unhappy with the sharpness of your images and you're ready to either micro-adjust it or send it into the camera manufacturer. Not so fast. Before you do that, let me walk you through the top 5 things you should take a look at before you send your camera in for repair. And this is all in relation to unsharp images. It is critical for me to note that there is a difference between tracking, focus, and sharpness. Those are 3 different things that we have to kind of separate. And there are a lot of other camera settings that can change how sharp the images result. So tracking has to do with the camera's ability to follow a moving subject, and every camera tracks a little bit differently, and there are some different settings to adjust on that. Focus has to do with if the lens is dialed in to the place that you want the camera to look at, and sharpness has to do with the performance of the lens as well as some of these other settings. So keep in mind that each of those 3 different things may be affecting the sharpness of your image. The first thing you should do when you get blurry images is take a look at user error. I know this is gonna be painful. One of the common things that I've seen so many times is the lens switch being turned from autofocus to manual focus. I see it over and over again among beginners. Second huge problem is sometimes they're trying to shoot sports with one shot instead of using something like the servo mode. The servo mode is a tracking setting that allows us to follow moving subjects and maintain focus as we are shooting. I've also seen it many times where people move to back button focusing and they're using their shutter button halfway depression and it's not working. So there's lots of little user error things that you need to eliminate before you come to the conclusion that your camera is broken. The second step I would recommend is take a look at your EXIF metadata. Critically important, the vast majority of times the culprit is going to be the shutter speed. If you are shooting a still subject, like for a portrait, minimum 1/60th of a second or faster, I recommend 1/100th of a second in some cases, just to make sure that there is no movement between your subject as well as you when you're holding the camera. It would be a mistake for me not to point out that there is something referred to as the reciprocal rule. Basically, you are going to take your focal length and turn it in to a fraction of 1/1 whatever your focal length is. An example would be, is if I'm shooting with a 400 millimeter lens, I would want to have a shutter speed of at least 1/400th of a second. And if you're dealing with sports and moving subjects, it just makes sense to even use a faster shutter speed, because if there's motion with a slow shutter speed, it's gonna be blurry. Which basically means that if you are shooting with telephoto lenses, 200, 300, 400 millimeters, your shutter speed is going to need to be faster the further you are zoomed in, because a little movement results in a lot of movement at the end of where you're looking at with your lens. There are also a number of other camera settings that can affect the sharpness of your images. For example, very high ISOs. When you get over 6400 and now the camera is adding all this noise reduction, that typically results in a loss of detail of the edges. There are a number of other little settings that can also affect that. I would say, but 90% of the time, it's the shutter speed. So the third thing that you should look at is your tracking settings on the camera. Every camera has different adjustments for how the camera is tracking. Fuji has some very robust ways to customize it. We saw something called the ITR problem on the Canon 90D. And we have to make sure that the camera's tracking ability matches with what you're trying to do. It's something that it would be impossible for me to cover every camera for every type of tracking situation, but just keep that in mind that there are ways to tweak some of those settings. Number 4, we have to take a look at the lens itself. Sometimes when we have very high resolving sensors, so many megapixel sensors, we need a lens that can resolve to that power. We saw it on the Canon 90D, there's a lot of pixels crammed in there, and some of those older lenses weren't strong enough to get a sharp image. It's also important to note that the sharpness of a lens changes as you are zooming in and out. I really strongly recommend learning MTF charts so you can know if it's you've just run into a limit of the lens when you're, you know, zoomed in. I've seen it on Tamron and Sigma lenses. Like when you're really, really zoomed in, it gets a little bit sharp. And that's just the limit of the lens, which would explain it. When you're seeing a soft lens, it always makes sense to test a different lens and kind of compare the results to make sure that it is coming from that one specific lens. If you've gone through all of those steps and you're pretty sure that you're doing everything right and it's not the lens and it's not a setting, it's not user error, any of those things, then it's time to start looking at micro adjustment. And again, you're going to want to test two lenses to make sure the camera is in focus. Suffice it to say, if you see a misfocus in both lenses, you're probably going to need to micro adjust the camera. If you see it in one lens, then you should at least attempt to micro adjust. So we have to go through all these four other steps before you get to micro adjustment, because what happens is beginning or intermediate photographers, they go in and they micro adjust and the problem is related to something else and it makes it a lot harder to track it down. If you get to the point that you're micro adjusting and you've checked everything else and you're really not sure what's going on, at that point, it is time to send the lens in. Now for me to go into micro adjustment in this video, it's just a little bit too much. So if you're interested in doing that and you wanna see my upcoming video on it, hit that notification bell and you will be notified when that video is ready. I'm sure you guys have some other comments on that. I would love to know in the description below. But in any event, before you micro adjust, before you send your camera in, take a look at all these steps in the sequential order and you're gonna save yourself a lot of time and frustration, because if the camera company gets it and there's nothing wrong with it, you know, they can still charge you and you're just gonna save yourself some money. I hope I've earned your subscription. Thank you guys for watching and I'll see you next time.